But he lived to tell the tale, and now he can see the moment it happened.
NBC2 anchor Brenna White made this happen. She actually tracked down an underwater drone team to go hunting for the camera that was lost in the attack.
911, what's the location of your emergency?
A guy got bit by an alligator. Please hurry up.
You never understand the power of wild animal like that until you're in its mouth.
Jeffrey Heim had been in the Myakka River for just over a minute.
He was bitten by an alligator?
Yes, he's right now. He's being real good.
How old is he?
When the amateur fossil hunter became the hunted.
Come up for a breath, and I felt like I got hit by a boat.
A 6.5-foot gator chomped down on his skull.
I thought it was. He's not near a lot of stitches.
Felt like propeller to the head, and it pulled me down.
Attached to the mask on his head, a GoPro recording the whole thing.
What it will show is it's not going to see the gator hit me. It's going to see it come off because it hit me from behind. I never saw it coming.
With the footage sitting at the bottom of the river, the truth about what happened was trapped only inside Jeffrey's head, held together by 35 staples.
Some people are accusing me of provoking the attack.
Hoping to prove his innocence, Jeffrey asked other divers to help him find the GoPro. That mission failed, but we had a different idea, and Jeffrey was eager to let us give it a go.
Yes, sir.
Veteran-owned tech company FlyMotion agreed to meet us on the river.
One of the teams that we work with the most, and especially in local public safety, is bomb squads. You know, we're helping put something else in harm's way in front of them.
With their underwater drone, typically used for public safety, government, and defense.
Most of the time, we're giving this equipment to first responders, the guys who are on the front lines that are, searching for people, lost swimmers. So it looks like we've got maybe a foot or 2 feet of visibility. Looks like you're in a good spot there, Chase. Maybe even more, a little bit in towards shore, if you can. We're getting to the right place here.
Less than an hour into our search, FlyMotion found a snorkel.
I cannot believe that.
And as their drone breached the surface...
It's got a GoPro on it.
Oh, my God!
Yes, sir!
Hey, great job, brother. That's super freaking cool. That's crazy.
I FaceTimed Jeffrey to share the good news.
Found your GoPro.
No way.
This is the guy that found it.
Hey, buddy.
Wow, you are really good at your job, because I had diver. Good job, guys. Thank you so much. I really, really hope I was filming.
He was. NBC2 can confirm the video shows the GoPro falling into the water as the gator attacks Jeffrey from behind.
Seems like the gentleman who lost it wants to see it real bad, and if he does, I'm excited for him.
Unfortunately, by the time this story aired, Jeffrey decided not to let us show you the footage we found, citing emotional distress.
You're lucky. Crazy story, huh? Well, you're lucky as hell.
Okay. Okay, so we can't show the video, I guess, but you saw it.
I did. So we got the GoPro that day. We came back and looked at it and, had our plans mm-hmm. to get it back to Jeffrey. So the GoPro's perspective is from the top of his head. So all you see about a minute into this video of him diving for fossils is the water. The GoPro splashes into the water and it floats to the bottom. So you never see the gator, you never see the jaws, you don't even see Jeffrey, his arms or anything. Just splashes right in.
The top of his head is still all of the evidence.
So sorry to not be able to show you, but I know it's frustrating just to hear what it is, but
still an amazing story.
Yeah. You can imagine. What it looks
I can't believe you found it.
I know.
Wow. I know, we were so excited. Yes. So happy we could get it back to him.
Pretty cool. Thanks, Brenna.